Sana. The height and reach advantage go to Sana, who's got the project armbands around his biceps here. The towering Frenchman. Huge experience as well goes the way of Samy Sana. 132 wins. Petrosian has 69 wins. Both men just testing the waters early here. Those four-ounce clubs are being employed tonight. Both men carrying very high guards, and rightly so. Petrosian tries to cut the angle, then goes downstairs with an outside thigh kick.
Sana's got a massive reach advantage of 10 centimeters. You gotta wonder how he's gonna use it. Utilize that nice big jab. Petrosian throwing that overhand right as he catches the kick there.
Petrosian looking for his first win in one Super Series. So too Samy Sana of France. Sana lost to Sorgro by decision last time out. Of course, Giorgio Petrosian just beat Sorgro by decision. Right hand there, counter right hand from Samy Sana. Drifts back to center cage. On the front foot, the Frenchman. Overhand right from Petrosian. They tango. Samy lands a short right hand. Petrosian trying to crack through the guard with a right hand of his own.
He's throwing a big overhand right, trying to reach that chin of Sana.
Two-punch combination for Petrosian, looping off both hands. Overhand right from Petrosian. That one had a lot of starch behind it. Samy Sana looks for the switch kick. Didn't fire it. Takes an inside leg kick. Left hand followed by a looping right there from Petrosian, but nothing connecting. Overhand right from Petrosian. Body kick from Samy Sana. Throws it again to the waist of Petrosian. Now they're picking up the speed here in the opening round. It's only 3x3 in one Super Series. You've got to work hard and fast early. Oh, tagging right hand from Samy Sana. Got the momentary wobbles there, did Petrosian. That right hand landed clean on the jaw. Samy Sana probing with the left. Petrosian falling forward. No knockdown, of course, says referee Onari. Maybe still recovering from that right hand, Petrosian. He drifts into the right hand, dangerously so. He's going to go the other way. He gets tagged again. He drifted straight into the right hand of Samy Sana.
He's trying to go away. Sana threw the kick, caught him with the body kick, and then before the foot even touched the ground, Sana was throwing that right hand and it connected right on the chin of Petrosian.
Petrosian's in trouble here. 30 seconds remaining in the first. A dump there from Samy Sana. And a caution from referee Onari. Can you find that right hand again? Petrosian's got to drift to his right. Into the left side of Sana, not into the right side of Sana. The right side's where the danger is.
Look how Sana's cutting off that angle. He's using those big, long legs to cut the corner so that Petrosian has to go to the right. He has to go to his left, and that can't go to the right.
Sana said he wanted to beat Armin Petrosian tonight, and then he wanted to face Giorgio Petrosian in 2019. First round down, we go to the towers. It's going to be a 10-8 round. Unofficially on my scorecard, a 10-8 round for Samy Sana.
Here's that work by Samy Sana. Caught the kick and boom, connected right on the button with that big right hand. Here's the second one. Look at that. Lifts up the right hand, fakes the right hand before he throws that leg again. That leg is on the way down. He's throwing that right hand, lands a hammer of a right hand.
Vote for the bounce of the night on the One Super app. You can win an all-expenses-paid trip to One Championship event. Download it now. It's all fights, all live, all free. Cut under the left eye of Armin Petrosian and Samy Sana, the Frenchman, on fire and looking fresh.
Yeah, he's looking good. He seems to have Petrosian figured out, at least in the first 2 minutes of that round. He's closing that distance well, cutting off the angle, making sure he drifts into his power side, and then he's landing that big right hand.
Second round of three inside the magnificent Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. It's a One Super Series kickboxing contest. France versus Italy. Samy Sana with the momentum in control, and he opens up strongly again. The straight line punches. There's the left hook from Armin Petrosian. Petrosian's got to drift the right way, got to keep the gloves up here. Good counter right hand there from the Italian, from Milan.
How he evaded that right hand of Sana. He's got to do more of that.
Jab two from Petrosian. Sana trying to stay planted in center cage here. These 4 ounce gloves make such a difference when it comes to the connection power. Thought about the left roundhouse kick, did Sana. Thought about it again. Finally goes to the inside lead leg. Didn't turn the knuckles into that right hand, Petrosian. High kick from Sana, going for the headache maker. Petrosian Left hook, leans back. Some better signs here from Armen Petrosian. Jab two, full extension from the Italian. Beautiful left hand there from Petrosian. Now gets backed up by Sana. Sana tries for a knee. And referee Onari breaks them.
See, Sana instinctually tries to go for that clinch, wants to close that distance, and then he remembers and he has to try to separate.
Sana edging forward. Oh, nice stiff hand there from Petrosian. Throws the overhand right.
Petrosian's trying to make up that reach factor by throwing that overhand right. In this round, it's starting to land.
This is a scintillating second round of ONE Super Series kickboxing action. Samy Sana doubles up the outside leg kick to the lead thigh. Just to that common peroneal nerve above the lead knee of Armen Petrosian. Again, Petrosian just losing his footing there. No knockdown, of course. Sana on the front foot. Thought about a roundhouse kick. Overhand right from Petrosian, catches the forearms. Sana, a nice high knee to the sternum there from the Frenchman. Gotta make sure that he curls the fist there, Samy Sana, and doesn't throw with the fingers extended. Step through knee from the Frenchman. And referee Onari breaks them. 45 seconds on the clock here in the second round, Dragon.
Better round for Petrosian. He's starting to find his mark. He's starting to close that distance, and he's getting inside the reach of Sana.
Sana looking for the right hand. The step through knee was nicely done. You can see the reddened left side of the body of Armen Petrosian. Leans back effectively there to Sana. Overhand right from the Italian. Can't find the way through the forearms guard. Back against the wire here, Petrosian needs to get off there. He's a sitting target. High knee from Sana. Petrosian's got to get off the fence, and he does now.
Sana does a good job of catching that kick, then just disrupting the balance just a little bit of Petrosian by throwing it up in the air and then coming over with a punch.
We go into the third round. Some better signs there from Armen Petrosian as Mehdi Zatut lifts up his charge, Samy Sana.
First round looked really sharp for Sana, but Petrosian starts to surge back in some of the exchanges. Sana, this is where they had an initial tanglement. Petrosian started to turn away, but that's just because the pressure from Sana is so intense. Michael Civello, unofficially, of course, how do you have it scored so far?
10-8 opening round, unofficially. I'll go the way of Samy Sana. Second round, better signs from Armen Petrosian, but I'll still edge it the way of Samy Sana, 10-9.
Oh, interesting. I wasn't expecting that. Okay, Michael Civello.
I thought Petrosian was a lot more active in the second round, Mitch, but he didn't land as much as he tried to throw, and Samy Sana was a little more precise. May not have had the volume of Petrosian, but landed more than Petrosian, from what I saw.
Okay.
Third and final round.
Again, Michael Civello is not an official judge. He just pretends to be one on TV.
The Mall of Asia Arena. I look around this magnificent stadium and we're at about 97% now. Leg check from Petrosian to start the third and final. Oh, he tagged him on the jaw with that one. Is this the moment for Petrosian? Is that the opening he needs? Can he follow through here, the Italian? He momentarily stunned Samy Sana with that right hand.
See the knees just sort of buckle ever so slightly of Samy Sana.
Dead center of the cage. Jab, right hand. The old 1-2 there from Petrosian. Deep kick to the lead leg. Fakes the right cross.
Nice evasion by Sana. He's able to see those punches coming. He countered with a knee.
Looping left hook there from Petrosian. Then dances out of the way of trouble. The old 3-2. That's his brother's favorite combination. The old 3-2. The hook to the cross.
Throws it out of the orthodox stance, so it's a bit different coming. It doesn't come with quite the same velocity that Giorgio throws it with, but it's still very effective.
What an amazing story, the Petrosian brothers in the martial arts world. They grew up in the most abject poverty, escaped war-torn Armenia. We're living at a train stations and in the gutters on the streets in Milan, Italy, with their dad. Eventually turned their lives around and found the martial arts. And they both sit atop the martial arts world, especially Giorgio Petrosian, the greatest kickboxer of all time, in the corner of his brother Armen Petrosian tonight, who's got 90 seconds remaining. Left hook there from Petrosian. Right hand lead. Samy Sana has slowed down. That right hand came agonizingly close. Just needed a bit more extension. Jab two from Sana. There's a knee at short range from the Frenchman. Has somebody got what it takes to go kleptomaniac and steal it in the last minute?
Sana, it looks very impressive when he's the one moving forward, when he's the one engaging. And that's what this is. It's just about keeping the other foot, the other opponent on your back foot. If you're dominating, if you're moving forward, you're winning the match.
45 seconds now. Petrosian just popped him on the nose as Sana tried to step through with the knee. Spinning back fist there from Petrosian. Counter right hand from Sana on a flying knee. Nicely done from the Frenchman. Referee Onari breaks them. Got to commit here. Petrosian does so with the right hand. Sana got to the outside of it. Good evasion from the Frenchman. Little mouse under the left eye of Petrosian. Hasn't been a lot of clean strikes landed here from Sana. Final seconds now. Sana offering his chin. Trying to sucker Petrosian in. Fires a right hand as a lead punch. No elbows allowed in this one. Final seconds indeed. We are going down to the judges here in Manila. Wherever you're watching, folks, live on Facebook, live on Twitter, live on the One Super app, how do you score it? Do you have it for Samy Sana? Do you have it for Armin Petrosian?
Very close round there. Samy Sana looked really good. He was the one pushing forward. Let's take a look at this big right hand from Petrosian. Look at that. Parried the hands down and came right over the top with that right hand. Samy Sana answers back with one of his own. There's that right hand that was missing just a little bit of extension. Samy Sana says, nope, my turn now. Lands a hook and continues to push forward. Very entertaining One Super Series matchup. Kickboxing rules with small gloves, Michael Cervello.
Doesn't get any better than that. Do the faces tell a story? I believe they do. Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Samy Sana.
A contender Asia title in the Spirit Arena in 2008. Undefeated in his last 31. Samy Sana needs to use the reach, needs to use the knees. Cannot allow Yod on the inside because Yodsanklai's left hand and Yodsanklai's left roundhouse kicks are straight from the depths of hell.
I like how he opened up with that left high kick, or right high kick rather, and he just keeps that left hand nice and tight to Yod's face. Also keeps him at range. He's got to keep him at distance. Utilize that long reach advantage that he's got. He's got almost 19 centimeters in height advantage. He's got to use it.
Yodsanklai taking his time, seeing what Sana has to offer, trying to find a way to get inside the long arms, the long legs of the towering Frenchman. Nice check there from Sana. Yodsanklai doubles up to the lead leg. And there's the first real taste of the left hand of Yod. Fans have tipped Yodsanklai and Petrosian to make it through the final of this historic featherweight Grand Prix tournament. But Samy Sana says he has the keys to unlock Yodsanklai tonight and take Yod out of the bracket.
Wants to use that right kick a lot, and he's doing it already. He's just got to go to the body, go to the inside of the leg, and go up top. Just over and over. You know, it's kind of impressive that, like, Yodsanklai's first match in Muay Thai was for 63 cents, which was 20 baht, and now he's two matches away from $1 million.
Yodsanklai, nice high guard there from Yod, just defending, goes to the back leg of Samy Sana, trying to connect with the right hand, that being the jab of the southpaw Thai. Sana thrusts out the jab, inside leg kick from the Frenchman. High guard on Sana as well, it should be. Backs up Yodsanklai with a good roundhouse kick off the back leg, turning left hook from Sana, who will advance to face Dzhabar Askerov in the semi-final round. High kick again from Sana, looking for the headache maker. Yod probing with the jab, setting the left hand.
Nice jab by Yodsanklai.
Yodsanklai competed against the great Wayne Parr three times, and Parr said that every time he competed against Yod, well, he aged 10 years. He's just watching. Nice head evasion there. Body shot from Watson. Sana tries to back him up with a knee. There's a left hook from Sana. Yod goes to the bread basket again. Got to get off the ropes here, Yod, and he does. Roundhouse kick from Yodsanklai. Sana with the uppercut. Yodsanklai tries to power through the double forearms guard. We've been used to seeing Yodsanklai so far in one super series in the four rounds class.
Shock like that. Look at this. Samy Sana. Oh, look at that. It was the kicks. That's what happened. He caught him right on the chin with that beautiful red high kick. And you can see he never quite got over it. And then Sana lands that big hook. Samy Sana just got a 10-8, Michael Schiavello. How do you feel about that?
Clean knockdown for Samy Sana. It was a beauty. Have a look at this. Lands that right hand perfectly. Backs up Yodsanklai here. Yodsanklai wide open. It was just timing from Samy Sana. I don't believe Yodsanklai's hurt from it, but it was a knockdown nonetheless. Samy Sana will be oozing out of every pore with confidence now, and Yodsanklai needs to reset, and reset in a hurry.
How can he not be hurt from it? He fell twice. He got up, and then he fell back down. It has to be hurt.
No. Yeah, I don't believe he's hurt. I don't believe there's any lasting damage from that, Mitch. I believe Yod got up from it, no problem. But it's a knockdown. It scores well for Samy Sana. But Yod's okay. Let's see how he recovers here.
Like, well, you're seeing something that Mitch and I are not. Clearly saw a knockdown that hurt.
Roundhouse kicks now from Yod. We'll see him turn up the artillery now. Turn up the mercury, especially off that back leg. And he cracks him out of the ribs of Samy Sana. Jab from Yod.
I didn't believe it when Samy Sana said he was going to stand there and trade with Yod, and he's doing just that. He's going zero space, and he let the combinations go. Yod's got to move.
Yodsanklai getting covered here by Samy Sana on the inside, and now Yod rallies back. But Samy Sana hit him with the uppercut.
Somebody's gonna fall. These guys are letting it all go.
Yodsanklai jab, then goes to the body.
Stop!
Looks like a dump here does Samy Sana. And referee Delapta says, no, 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 this isn't Muay Thai.
Good balance shown by Yod there. He's able to stay up on his feet.
Stop! No catching either. A warning there again from Elias Delapta. Good refereeing from him. Yodsanklai goes to the body. Sana throws the uppercut. Yodsanklai. It's been a while since he's been in the bigger gloves. As I said, previously in one Super Series, it's all been four-ounce gloves, and he's been decimating opponents. He's trying to knock out Samy Sana now. Here they go, toe-to-toe. Amazing scene, Tiamisha. You've got to be loving this.
Wow. I'm just on the edge of my seat. I just know one of them is about to go down. I will say that Yodsanklai has got to be careful about dropping that backhand, because when you have the tall fighter, Samy Sana, he's bringing up that knee and that kick. One of those can really be deadly.
Who will advance to the semifinal round to take on Dzhabar Askerov? Who will move a closer step to US $1 million? Oh, Samy Sana looks the head back. And Yod makes sure his mouth guard's still intact. Mitch, this is just ferocious. This is phenomenal. This is one Super Series kickboxer.
Yeah, I like how Yod's using that uppercut inside, but he's got to be careful, because as he's bringing his hands up, he's letting his hands drop. He's so comfortable, and he relies on his power so much. Big right hand landed by Sana.
Samy Sana lands the right hand to Yodsanklai. There's a left hook from Yod on the uppercut. Sana's got it. Scenes here in Singapore. This is a sketch. This is a battle. This is what it's all about.
pure theater. It's pure buff offense. It's one Super Series match, and it's awesome.
Look at Sana just putting in work. Beautifully timed shots. Look at that. Good covers up. Big gloves are going to help that. Sana says, all right, my turn. You go, I go. You go, I go. And Sana just put together a five-piece combination right there and adds two more with an extra drink. But then Yod says, all right, my turn. You got me. I'm going to get you. That uppercut, that's doing the dirty work. Look at that. He goes back to it. Clay, oh, you're starting to see the eyes wobble back. But Sana was able to regain it and go right back in. You can't clinch, though.
Okay, Misha, unofficially, that second round, unofficially, who do you give it to?
Oh, to score that one, I think I was too enthralled with it. I don't even know. That was just an epic round. I don't care who won that round, to be honest. I'm the winner of that round, just getting to watch it.
That's the perfect word, sold out. Not one empty seat inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium.
Ready?
This has been an amazing third and final shutdown on Yodsanklai in the third. Yod rallied back in the second. Looked like he may have come close to dropping Sana, but it didn't happen for the tie. And here they go toe-to-toe again. You get flashes of 2001 in Fukuoka, Mark Hunt versus Ray Seppo in an all-time K-1 classic. We're seeing the makings of an all-time one Super Series classic. Body shot from Yodsanklai, step up knee from Samy Sana. Yod tries to force him back with the hands.
You can see Sana's trying to. Oh, he caught him with a big right hand off the kick.
Now Yodsanklai feels it. Now Yodsanklai home. Here comes Samy Sana. Samy Sana can sniff it. He can sense it. He can smell it. Yodsanklai might be right for the picking. And referee Delantis cautioning Samy Sana.
Can't clinch. That's what he's warning him of. You can see Sana was trying to get in there, but he was just letting those close range strikes go.
Yod goes to the body. He's taking far too much head punishment, though, Yodsanklai. He's got to be smart now. He's got to understand why they call in the boxing computer. You've got to think about it, Yod. You can't stand in that phone booth and let Samy Sana rain up punches on you. Body shot from Yod. Knee there from Samy Sana. A tremendous battle of attrition. This is when you've got to dig deep. This is when it's more than kicks, more than punches. It's guts. It's intestinal fortitude. It's that Bushido spirit, Mitch.
Man, they are just trained. You can see the spit. There's just a bunch of
flying.
I had to pause because I saw it.
How about that? How taste my feet?
Oh, my God. Just eating these shots, Michael.
And Yodsanklai rallies back. Samy Sana has hit him with some absolute anvils. The uppercut from Samy Sana.
This could be a giant upset by a lot if Samy Sana is able to pour it on here the last 60 seconds of the match.
Sana said he could do it. He said he had the keys to unlock the riddle of Yodsanklai. Rocks the head back again.
Stop! Separate!
And there's no defense. They're just catching all the punches with their face.
Yodsanklai goes to the jaw of Sana. A right hand from Sana. A step through knee again. Sana comes forward, locks up Yod, and referee Delopsis breaks them. 45 seconds remains. Throws the knee again. Yod's got to go to work now. He's got to put the foot down. Pull out all the stops. Caution to the wind. It's time for Yod to go. But has he got it in the tank, the veteran?
30 seconds left in the final round.
Yodsanklai, so many people's overwhelming favorite removed from this tournament. Stop. Are we going to see him eliminated at the hand, the knee, the kicks of Samy Sana? The right hand again from Sana. Yodsanklai trying to get through, trying for the knockout punch, the knockout roundhouse kick, but it's not coming for it.
Super Series athlete Benny Zatun celebrating in the corner like his boy came away with the victory. And Sana jumps up into the corner. We got to see some highlights of that round because it was filled with them over and over, just going toe to toe. You could have tied these two together because there was no movement, just standing in front of him. Look at that, sucking on the heel of the foot there from Samy Sana. But then Sana still comes back. Look how he takes it on the arm, tries to parry it away, and then just comes straight down the middle with a huge right hand from Samy Sana.
Misha, we are absolutely breathless and speechless after that. It was incredible.
Incredible is exactly what I was thinking. A really, really close round. I think because of the first round, Samy Sana may be walking away here with a giant upset. What do you guys think?
I think it's going to be close, but you know what? If I had to edge one way, and again, folks, strictly unofficially, a 10-8 opening round, Samy Sana, I'd edge it to Samy Sana.
Is Yod get the last two, or did Samy? I don't think it's an edge. I might be, I don't know.
No draws in one of the series, folks. Let's see what happens. Who goes through?
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And advancing to the one featherweight kickboxing World Grand Prix semifinal, and one step closer to the $1 million US dollar grand prize from the blue corner, Samy Sana.
Samy Sana towers over Askarov by 20 centimeters. Askarov will want to get on the inside and land the heaviest elbows. Those clubbing hands of the Russian.
Go!
A lot of kicks coming from Sana early. Keeping Dzhabar at the end of his range.
One way to slow down the boxing of Askarov is to kick the Russian's legs. Askarov, who calls Melbourne, Australia home these days, actually went to Russia and trained for this one. Circling off to his right, Askarov staying away from the power side of Samy Sana. Sana checks the low kick, immediately cuts off the circle. Good work here from Samy Sana. Outside low kick from Samy Sana.
Just circling around each other, throwing, exchanging those kicks, circling clockwise.
Jumping into a right hand there, Askarov. We do believe that some of his contender Asia alumni are in the audience tonight here in Bangkok, including Zigzag. The reality series that shot Askarov to worldwide stardom back in 2008. 11 years later, still on top of the world, Dzhabar Askerov. Samy Sana, who shocked the world when he took out Yodsanklai IWE Fairtex in the quarterfinals. Samy Sana going for the headache maker. Round kick to a right hand from Sana, using his length well, the Frenchman. Two world champions inside the circle as Askarov tries to lay on the power with the club. Outside leg kick Sana, Askarov sweeps out the flip. Sana calling him forward. Askarov won't be sucked into anything, though. You see again, Sama wants Askarov to engage in a Donnybrook, in a brawl. Askarov not going there. Outside leg kick from Askarov. Left hook. Oh, smack back! First knockdown! Three knockdowns in the round, it's over. There's the first one. Samy Sana smack back in the jaw of Dzhabar Askerov.
Wow, what a beautiful right hand by Sana there. I don't know if Java's recovered from that. He still looks a little bit shaken. This is Sana's opportunity. Uppercuts.
Askarov's gonna go off the fence here. Here it comes, Samy Sana with the right hand. And a high knee. There's the right hand again. Askarov does a quick hook. Count of his teeth.
Go!
Samy Sana with a 10-8 round in the third. Samy Sana dropping Dzhabar Askerov.
Sana just looking like a gangsta out there, just calling him to the center. Look at this, left hand, boom, with the right hook right down the middle. Almost sends Askarov through the circle door there, beautifully timed. You can see that's what Sana was waiting for. That's why he gestured him into the middle. Sana letting those hands go.
It's the length at the moment, Mitch, that is giving Askerov problems. He's failing to get on the inside. He's standing in that no man's land at range of the punches and the kicks of Samy Sana.
But Michael, he's not even trying to close the distance. All he's doing is circling to the outside, which is keeping him at the end of Sana's range.
Do not rule out Dzhabar Askerov. Don't forget, folks, follow us across social media at One Championship on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and Instagram. This crowd inside the Impact Arena on the edge of their seats. Who will put their place? October 13, Tokyo, Japan. US $1 million on the line for the winner of the Featherweight Kickboxing World Grand Prix. High kick there from Samy Sana. Askarov's got to find a way to bridge the gap.
Sana wants him on the inside. Sana is calling forward, making sure he stays in front of him. But Jabba's circling around, staying at the end of the range. Might be working to Sana's advantage.
Haven't seen Askarov throw the rolling thunder. He did so a lot against Enrico Kell in his quarterfinal win. Sana front kick. Controlling center circle, the towering Frenchman, 20 centimeters taller than Askarov. Comes off the circle again to Sana. Cerebral footwork from Samy Sana. Right hands were left to him. Thought about switching, goes downstairs. Askarov continues to circle counterclockwise. There's a left hook from Askarov. Step through knee from Samy Sana. They tie up, and referee Onari breaks it.
You can see, like, Askarov's comfortability inside this circle. He's been in there before. He is 8-0 in mixed martial arts, and he is using the entire circle to at least what he believes could be his advantage. But Sana, he's staying at the end of the range of Sana's shots.
Left hook there from Askarov now. He gets back to center circle. Can he stay there? Jamal Askarov throws the right. Samy Sana right hand counter near the tune, slowly forcing Askarov back to the outside.
Just trimming the whiskers of Sana with that monstrous right hand of his.
The footwork. Go. The circle control of Samy Sana is phenomenal so far. Look at the little footstep to the side, the lateral movement that cuts off the circular movement of Askarov. See again, he cuts off the movement, and there's a right hand. Samy Sana doing everything right, and Askarov having a lot of problems. He's got to change tact here, Dzhabar Askerov. Continually circling off to his right isn't working for Genghis Khan. But what does he do? How does he change it up? How does he swing the pendulum? Again, Samy Sana cuts off the movement. Askarov dances out of the way of trouble.
30 seconds left in the side round
from Samy Sana. Rolling thunder! Samy Sana playing mind with Askarov. Mocking him, shaking his head, trying to frustrate Askarov. He wants Askarov to charge in and try and brawl with him, because when Askarov does that, watch for the rising knee of Samy Sana. And there's one in the midsection. Almost two rounds down. Three judges circle side, scoring at a 10-point mark system. Give the winner of the round 10 points, the less dominant boxer 9 points. First round would have been a 10-8 round to Samy Sana, courtesy of the knockdown. And look at the glittering ocean of fans inside the Impact Arena. They are enthralled by the first semi-final of the Featherweight Kickboxing World Grand Prix. And a world's record, $1 million on the line for the winner. Never in the history of kickboxing has such a purse been offered.
Michael, let's talk about what we're seeing right now. We're seeing Jabba continually circle to the right, trying to stay away from Sana, not engage in a firestorm with him, consistently circling. What do you think of this strategy?
At the moment, Mitch, I don't think it's playing out for Jabba. I think now it's time to enter the storm. Now it's time to go toe-to-toe and test your mettle against Samy Sana. Because staying on the outside, circling counterclockwise, keeping in that no man's land and allowing Samy Sana to get his range against you just isn't working for Askarov. Now it's time to get on the inside, bite down in the mouth guard, and go hell for leather and see if he can land one of those big tough thumpers off his hands. Third and final round. Inside is where Askarov needs to be. Outside is where he's staying. Jumping knee! Askerov.
See, Sana's trying to cut that angle. He's trying to corner him, press him up against that circle. Now he's got him changing directions.
And again, you see Sana trying to get inside the head of Askerov. He wants a brawl. He wants Askerov to be suckered in. Askerov still not taking the bait.
But you're saying that's Askarov's only chance is to get dirty with it, to get inside.
It has to be, because what he is doing, staying at range, is not working for Dzhabar Askerov. Unofficially on my scorecard, I've got Askerov trailing. It was a 10-8 first round, no doubt about that. The knockdown from Sana. I thought Sana won the second round 10-9. Askarov's got to change it up here. Staying on the outside won't do the job. Trust me, Askarov can brawl with the best of them. He's been doing so for a long, long time.
I think he hears you. I think that voice has been, you know, commentating him a long time, so he's obliging to you. He's trying to make it dirty. He's trying to throw shots, but Sana's just not there to receive him.
But this is Samy Sana at the height of his power, at his cerebral best.
Ever since Sana lost to Joe Nottawa back in February, we have seen a completely different Samy Sana.
You're right, Mitch. A whole different athlete, catching counter there from Dzhabar Askerov. 1:05 remaining for Dzhabar Askerov to somehow turn the tide. It's going to take something major from Askerov. He'll need to get a knockdown on Samy Sana here. And Sana continually doing it all right. Now on the inside, but then he backs off Askerov. Sana crawling him forward. Even the guard here of Samy Sana has been impenetrable. The double forearms guard, the high checks from his legs. Goes downstairs. Front kick. There's the reach again of Samy Sana. Looking for the jumpers. Kicks the legs. Where were the hands over the top for company, though?
Look at the hands. Look at the legs of Dzhabar. They just don't seem to be underneath him. They seem to be stiff and kind of Frankenstein-esque, and he's trying to move around.
You know that Petrosian and another one are watching this one backstage. The winner of this will take on the winner of Petrosian or another one in Tokyo on October 13 in the One Championship Century Show for US$1 million. We are going down to the judges. It is only Samy Sana who pumps his fists in the air and scales the circle fence. Wherever you're watching, folks, in over 140 countries around the world, we hope you enjoyed semi-final number one of the One Super Series Featherweight Kickboxing World Grand Prix. Who advances to Tokyo? One step closer to becoming a millionaire. Even in the heady days of K1, the most I believe, if I can remember right, that was ever offered by K1 for a winner of the Grand Prix was US$400,000. Here, it's US$1 million. You go back to the old days of the sport. You know, the Joe Louis days, the Bill Wallace days, and the Benny Okidas and Dennis Alexio and Maurice Smith days and Stan Longanidis days. Never a prize purse anywhere near this. Will it be the Frenchman? The look on Askarov's face, I believe, tells you that answer. A knockdown the first round for Samy Sana. Staying at range, teeing off on Dzhabar Askerov. Looks very fresh. Who will take the first step to the final? Let's go to Tom Lau and find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. And now, for your winner, by majority decision, advancing to the One Featherweight Kickboxing World Grand Prix Final, and one step closer to the $1 million grand prize, from the red corner, Samy Sana.
On the One Fantasy game, on the One Super app, 87% of fans tip Yodsanklai for the win. In Yod, we trust. First round of action set for three. Both men in southpaw stance. Look for that rear leg roundhouse kick of Yodsanklai. Look for the left cross of Yod and also the left cross of Yusupov. Yusupov needs to go hard early. Needs to plant his flag on Yodsanklai. Tell him I'm here! Yodsanklai, if he connects with that left hand to the jaw of Yusupov, Yusupov will starve to death rolling. High front kick there from Yusupov. Yodsanklai edging forward. Snappy jab, the high left round, trying to break down the forearms. And a jab again, threads it through the guard. Yodsanklai, flat-footed, he always is, because he's all power. Power with precision, that's Yodsanklai IWE Fairtex. Jab from Yusupov. Yodsanklai coming off that loss to Samy Sana in the featherweight kickboxing Grand Prix. That was eventually won by Giorgio Petrosian. That loss broker. Many, many years of being undefeated for Yodsanklai IWE Fairtex. The streak certainly continues in Muay Thai, though, where Yod has been untouchable for the last decade. Nice body shot there after the high fake from Yusupov. Cracking round kick, tucks it under the right arm, does Yod. The Prajit armbands, traditional of Muay Thai athletes around the biceps of Yodsanklai. Good kick there to the midsection, sends Yod's back a few paces. Jab from Yusupov. Already a small mouse forming over the right eye of Jamal Yusupov. Yod comes forward. Goes to the lead fight. Yusupov giving a good account of himself so far. That jab is terrific on Jamal Yusupov. I'm glad to see that Yodsanklai has gone back to his more traditional haircut. Against Samy Sana, he sported a haircut, a hairstyle that was, well, not his best. A lot of people seem to think it was the hairstyle that was one of his undoings. Yodsanklai catches the jabs from Yusupov. Good jab again.
10 seconds.
Yusupov just continually flicking that lead hand to the face of Yodsanklai. Switch up from Yod, end of round one. We've got three judges ringside, folks, who are scoring on a 10-point must system. Give the winner of the round 10 points, the less dominant athlete 9 points. Who do you give the first round to as we take a look at some of the action, Mitch?
You can see how Yodsanklai is adding up these little strikes to kind of build into something. He has a beautiful jab that's been connecting nicely, and then a big roundhouse connected to the top of the head of Yusupov. But it's the difference of each of these shots. You can see the power at which Yodsanklai lands, moves Yusupov, as opposed to Yusupov, who's just had his touching him, just lightly banging on him. But he's got to keep that volume coming, disrupt the rhythm of Yodsanklai IWE Fairtex. Slow down that big power he knows coming.
Now, for the first time tonight, we are rolling into the second round of action. Inside the sold-out Cadillac Arena in Beijing, China, it's one championship, Age of Dragons. Michael Chevallo, Mitch Chilson with you. The great Yodsanklai IWE Fairtex, one of over 140 martial arts world champions on the one championship roster. And have a look at this! Yusupov opens up like a house on fire! That's what he's gonna do! He's gonna go after the jaw of Yodsanklai! Well, it's a count here on Yod! It's a count on Yodsanklai! And Yusupov now has got the gusto!
Got knocked down!
Mitch, I'm stunned! but he did what he said he had to do. He pounced early on Yodsanklai in the first. He stamped himself. He came out like a bull out of the gate in the second round and tagged him and owned him and dropped him. Have a look at this.
You can see in the first exchange how he wobbled him, and then in this second exchange, you can see IWE Fairtex was hurt. And then Yusupov just kept pouring it on. What a huge debut for Yusupov to come in on this match on just days' notice and compete against one of the greatest of all time in Muay Thai in small gloves and to do that to him.
That is the most superb three-punch combination in four-ounce gloves you'll ever see. He unlocked the code. He put the malware in the boxing computer. The virus in Yodsanklai IWE Fairtex. They are going crazy in China for Jamal Yusupov, and rightly so. What an upset. What a shock. Jamal Yusupov, welcome to One Super Series. You, sir, are phenomenal.
If you didn't know his name before, everybody knows it now.
How this man did it. And in what style, in what fashion, knocking out the great Yodsanklai IWE Fairtex. I am still shocked. Here's Dom.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Cost, has called a stop to this contest after 39 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of knockout, Jamal Yusupov.